So now we are going to discussing about code analysis tool. So what is code analysis tool? That is about, there are many code analysis tools. Which we can use in project development for analyzing your code. So before deploying your code, you can check whether you are syntactically and your any other issues you can prevent by reviewing the code. So that is called code review. So before checking the code in the SVN, you have to review the code. So there are two ways you can review the code. By manually with the senior architects, you can review the code, or using some tools, you can review the code. So when manually reviewing the code, so the people who is expert in Java, they have more than 10 to 15 years of experience. So first they will review the code, whatever you develop for on particular change. So once they approved it, and they can, you can commit the code in the SVN. But even even the some tools you can use to know what is how the your code looks like. I mean, any errors or errors in the sense, programmatically there is no errors, but when you reviewed it, there are some errors, there are some issues may occur. So that we can identify using some code analysis tools. So that those are all Sonar and PMD. So these are all different tools we have to code review. So it will review the code from the scratch itself. So for this, now this is about code analysis tool. So this is about code analysis, not runtime monitoring. So you will not run, you will nothing you are going to running in with your code. So this is just to review your code, not to when you are doing running, that time you this tools will not review your code. Once you develop the code, then these tools will use to review it. So that is what it is going now. Okay, so we have already developed a project, a simple app and a simple web app. Okay, so these two projects we have developed. Now I am going to reviewing these two projects, or one. So I am going to reviewing these projects using some code review tools. Manually I reviewed it, so I don't find any issues because I have two files. One is app.java here. So this is contain one main method and hello world, that's it. And services.java is another file. So it contains some loggers and two methods. I didn't find any issues in this file. And in the same way, test.java. So I'm going to reviewing the all Java files. So here also I don't find any issues. Okay, so nothing is there. So from my end, I don't find any issues here. So that's why I'm not going to I am giving sign off for these files to commit it. So but let me verify, let me review this code using some tools. So this is manually I am doing reviewing. So there I didn't find any issues in this code. So but let review the code through tools. So those tools will throw any errors or something, it will find it out. Let me verify it. So another project, simple web app. So this also we developed here also. So this is the code we have implemented. So I didn't find any issues here, and nothing is there. So this is only file Durga Servlet. So this is the file. So I didn't find any issues. I am giving the sign off to access these services. Now, so I am giving the sign off to commit this code. But the problem is, before committing the code, manual review is done. Now I am going to reviewing this code by some code analysis tools. So these code analysis tools will review this code, and the tools will find any root cause, any issues which is there in this project. Okay, so before started working with code analysis tools, first we will know what is code analysis tool. So code analysis tools, it is to review the code, not at runtime. This presentation is not about the performance analysis tool like profiling, JConsole, debugging tool. So like this is not related to performance analysis. It is not a performance analysis, it is a code review. So performance analysis is different and code review is different. Performance analysis means, suppose your application is throwing out of memory error. Okay, let's say so you have given for your application heap size is 1 GB, but number of users they are accessing and they are trying to getting, so if the memory size is increased to more than 1 GB, so that time what happened is your application is going to be down by causing out of memory error. So in that scenario, so you have to find it out why out of memory is error coming. So for that you have to use some profiling tools and JConsole and some debugging tools to find it out the memory monitoring. So how my heap is increasing. So if 100 employees is 100 users are accessing that time, what is my heap size and how my heap is working? If 1000 users accessing my site, how heap is working? And if 10,000 people accessing my site, then how my heap is working? So such a information we can track using these tools, profiling tools, JConsole tools, debugging tools. But now we are discussing about code analysis tools. That tools is not related to performance analysis like heap memory monitoring. So whatever the tools we are currently going to discuss, that is not related to performance or to monitoring the memory. Okay, so this tool will inspect the code. So that it will inspect the code and find it out any logical errors, and it will report it. Okay, what is the errors it may contain. So that type of inspection it will do. And more studies have found that the inspections are cheaper than testing. A study of the software engineering laboratory found that code reading detected about 80% more faults per hour than testing. So instead of saying error, we can say it as false. So errors means it will show red color. False means it will not show red color, but some fault may be there in the code. So that is what the difference between fault and error. So this code analysis tool, using this code analysis tools, we can find the faults in the application. Okay, so we can reduce the, so if we after review the code by some code analysis tool, and after fixing that whatever the report is given by the analysis tool, if we implement it in the same way, so it is very useful, and it is your code is very clean. That means, so your code is very clean code. So as per the code review analysis tool, you modified the code, then your code is clean. Next one is advantages of code review tools. Track suggestions. So it will provide some suggestions. Allow follow-up on tasks. So some follow-ups on tasks, and aid in comparing before and after changes. So we can compare the changes. Source code repository integration. So we can directly do the review on SVN itself. So if you given the SVN URL, this tool, what it will do is it will check out the code from the SVN and it will perform the code review on that code. So that is how it will work. So code review issues, time consuming, belittling, boring, embarrassing, maybe rubber stamping. So by these are the main things these tools will look into the code. So suppose you write some for loop. Okay, so in the for loop you are trying to iterating 1 to 10, and you are using some condition inside that. So no need to verify, no need the condition in such scenario. So it will throw an error. So why do you using if condition inside that? So that is not required at all. So such a issues it will find it out. So at the logic level, how the code is taking more time to execute certain functionality. So that and all, it will find it out. Time consuming, belittling, boring and embarrassing, maybe rubber stamping. So these are the issues these tools will focus. Next one is, so there are different types of code analysis tools what we currently. So find bug is one tool that we can use to review the code. PMD is another tool. We can use this PMD to review the code. Check style, J depend, CKJM, CPD, Java, CSS, COBOL, Trova, JXR, Java Doc. So these are all different types of code review tools we can use to review the code. And see, we are going to discussing about Sonar and PMD. These two tools we are going to discussing. So find bugs and these things we are not going to discuss. So but the way is common, but the backend implementation is different. That's it. So if you try to review the code using Sonar, so you can review the code with PMD, find bugs, anything you can do it. So that is what it means. So it will report, it will come find. Okay, now we will discuss PMD. So PMD scans the Java source code and looks for the potential problems like possible bugs, dead code, suboptimal code, over complicated expressions, duplicate code. So these are the problems this PMD will check in the code. So any possible bugs like empty try, empty catch, finally. So you open the try and if you put empty catch, that is meaningless. So this code review tool PMD will check that it identified any possible bugs. So any empty catch block, empty finally block, empty switch statements, such a things is there or not, it will track it in the same way dead code. So you have unusual local variable parameters and private method. So you created local variable and you are not using that. So that is dead code. So such a dead code it will identify. Next, suboptimal code, wasteful string buffer usage. So in Java, string and string buffer, it is very more important concept. So it is a string is a immutable object. So if you keep the string and you created a string object and you are not using, then memory location is waste. It means so you need to release the string objects eventually, otherwise it may throw out of memory exception. So that is the chance if you are not using properly string objects. So that's why you have to use. So in such things this PMD will optimize it. Over complicated expressions, so unnecessarily if statements, for loops, that could be while loop. So if statements, unnecessarily if we have if statements, for loops, then it will identify that one. And duplicate code, so copied and pasted code means copied and pasted bugs. So again, if the same thing, if you copied in different place, so such duplicate code it will find it out. So using this PMD will look the faults in these areas: possible bugs, dead code, suboptimal code, over complicated expression, duplicate code. So these are the areas it will find it out the bugs. Now PMD rule set, so these are the rule set it have: Android rules, basic JSF rules, basic JSP rules. So it will do some, it have some rule set. So based on that rule set, it will review the code. Next one is PMD rule example. So simple example like empty catch block. So you have a try block and you catched it, and in the catch block nothing is there. so meaningless. So such a but it will not throw any error, it will not throw any exception. But when you review the code, this tool will identify it. Okay, why do you putting catch block empty? So such a message it will show. And if empty if statement, so you created if condition and inside if nothing is there, so it will throw the message that you are using empty if message, if condition. Why do you using in the code? And the same way, if empty while statement, empty try block, empty finally block, empty switch block, jumbled incrementer, for loop should be while loop. Okay, so these are all PMD basic rules which it can use for tracking the faults in the code. So this is Maven PMD configuration. I will use direct PMD. Okay, so this is I am not going to using PMD example report. So once it review the code, once you run the PMD, so it will generate one report. So that report will show you the list of faults in the code. So that one it will show it. Next one is check styles. Check styles we are not going to using. We are going to discussing sonar. So sonar and PMD. So PMD sonar now we discuss dashboard. So if you open sonar, so dashboard summarize static and dynamic analysis tool, convention, bad practices, potential blocks. So sonar is having everything like what check style, PMD, find bugs, everything is inside sonar, like bad practices that we can implement, that we can identify using PMD, conventions. So you see age is there, int age equal to 30. So instead of 30, that age if you specify int name equal to 30, so that is wrong. So such a conventions, naming convention should be proper. So that conventions we can identify by check styles. Bad practices like empty if condition, empty if statement, empty for loop, empty try block. So such a bad practices we can identify by PMD tool. Potential bugs, so some bugs that we can find out by find bugs. All these functionalities we can implement, we can find by sonar. So that is the beauty of sonar. Now sonar example, so it will show you the dashboard like this. Okay, so simple sonar application we will so now we will review our code using sonar and PMD. Okay, I have a sonar, I downloaded the sonar in my machine. So this is my sonar. Now I am starting the sonar. So my machine is 64 bit. So sonar cube bin. So this is the bin folder for 64. Now I am starting start sonar.bat. Start sonar.bat. So it is going to okay, so something here temp. So I am going to deleting these things. Now I am starting sonar again. No, sonar cube temp. So this process access because it will be another process. So what I will do is already my services sonar. I am going to deleting this file now. So somebody is using this, it means What we can do is, so this is Java. So what I will do is I will in process. Now I'm trying to removing this. Yes, okay, so now I'm going to starting sonar cmd sonar cube bin. Start sonar done. Wrapper simple app file system exception. The process cannot access the file because it is being used by another process. So actually I started already, so that's why some exception is coming. So this is not going to be this. So okay, so what I am going to doing is see, this is my project, simple app is my project. Now I am trying to debugging this, sorry, I am going to reviewing this code using sonar. So for this I am run as maven build and install sonar colon sonar. So this is how I am applying, I am running my sonar. So sonar is, so sonar is not running. So first we need to run the sonar. So sonar is not running means